If you are making the decision to homeschool your kids, congratulations. You came across the right video. Today, I'm going to show you how you can actually start homeschooling. So stay tuned and I'll see you after. So you've made the decision to homeschool your child this year. Congratulations. In this short video, I will go over the steps you need to take to get going. But first, let's discuss the benefits. Number one, you now have control over your own schedule and are no longer slaves to the school calendar. Think of the freedom. No more late nights of homework or missing the school bus. Number two, academic flexibility. If you'd like to have science in the kitchen today, go at it. You have the flexibility to follow the passions of your child. Take as long as you like on a particular topic or subject and get as in-depth as you want. For example, if you have a budding engineer or builder, break away from the conventional books for a couple of days and challenge them to find a building app online, research their local planning and zoning guidelines, and potentially interview someone from the office. You can now give your kids real-world applications of what they'll need to be successful. Number three, a warm, friendly environment. One that's free from bullying, vulgar language, or kids putting your child down over clothes, hair, and accent or skin color. I have yet to ever meet a person or read an article where someone claims that bullying throughout their school years made them a better person. You're in control now and can provide the optimal learning environment for your child. Now, on to the steps that you need to take to begin your homeschooling journey. Number one, you will need to notify your school and Board of Education of your intent to homeschool your child in the upcoming school year. This can usually be done online or by mail. Number two, make a decision of how you would like to report back to the state. You may report directly to your local county Board of Education or report through an umbrella group. An umbrella group is an organization that supervises or oversees our family's homeschooling endeavors. Some groups are in person and some groups are via the mail or online. For example, your local church may have a homeschool umbrella that you would like to join for a small fee. Many umbrella groups only report one time a year, whereas if you report directly to your local Board of Education, you will most likely report two times, approximately in December and again around April or May. Number three, choose a curriculum or make up your own with free resources from your local library. You will want to check your state laws to ensure that the curriculum you choose is in line with the guidelines. For example, in the state of Maryland, your obligation for education is regular and consistent education in 8 subjects. Number four, maintain a portfolio. Remember to keep a record of your child's work. You can do so through pictures, videos, online work with a memory stick, or traditional workbooks and worksheets. For high school age students, you need to consider graduation starting in 9th grade. Are you interested in gaining a diploma or would you like to take a GED? Is your child planning on college? The last 2 years can be completed at a local community college where kids just need to be 16 years old to attend. They can actually graduate at 18 with an associate's degree and a diploma at the same time. If you find yourself unsure on how you will handle teaching a particular subject, here are some options. Hire a tutor. There are so many teachers out of work right now, as well as college students that would be happy to earn a couple of extra bucks. Or you could join a homeschool cooperative. A co-op is a group of homeschool families that get together for the benefit of socialization, field trips, education, and more. However, if you can find a free meeting space in someone's home, local church, or community center, you can start your own. Simply invite parents, secure a Facebook page for group communication, and start a parent board. This parent board will make decisions for the group at large, decide on nominal dues to collect, and a day of the week you plan to meet and take field trips. Generally, all families help with the education in some way. For instance, if you have a parent that has a true lifelong love of science, they could teach a 6-week science class. If you have another parent that is very crafty, they could teach an art class. The dues that you all agree upon help pay for supplies. I've seen so many kids make lifelong friendships from their homeschool cooperatives. Another idea is if you have a small group of kids with parents passionate about taking on education, take a survey on who is interested in alternating subjects. Maybe on Mondays they go to one house for English, and on Wednesdays they go to another house for science,
The possibilities are literally endless. So, as you can see, the homeschooling world is full of opportunity. Congratulations on making a wonderful decision for you and your family. If you have any other questions, please leave them in the comment section and I'll be sure to respond.
Hey there again. I hope that was helpful for you. This was a collaboration with Grow With Samantha, the YouTube channel. I'm going to link all of her information in the description box below so you can check out her channel. She's got some really cool crafts and things like that for your kids that you can check out there. And if you have any other questions, be sure to leave them for me in the comment section, or you can actually DM me or comment on any of my Instagram posts. Find me at Junk Drawer Mom, of course. I'll link all that stuff in the description box below for you. And as well, I'll put all of my other homeschool videos there for you. Don't forget, hiding is overrated, and I'll see you next time.